And now we will learn how to send the invoice that you just made. Email is the method that QuickBooks app uses to send the invoice. You just reopen the invoice after you save it, tap the Send Invoice bar, and enter the email address of the customer, or at least the recipient of the invoice. You could also enter some note or message in the text of the email. Now, to send an invoice, all you have to do is open it from either the main activity list or the activity list of that customer. If I tap activity up here, you can see invoice number 6 for Debbie Reynolds is right here. And I can tap on it, and it says send invoice. That means the app knows you haven't sent it yet. Well, it's very simple. You swipe to the right, tap on it. Okay, now it's asking for the email address. You can tap into the field, and then you type the email address where it's going. Now, I'm going to send this to my email address so I can log in and show you what it looks like when you send the customer the invoice through email. So I'm going to enter worldwidequickbooks@gmail.com. So I entered that off camera, and now, of course, you're supposed to put in the invoice number, so I can tap here, remove what QuickBooks put, and put 6. Okay, of course, you can adjust the text any way you want, and you can pretty much put anything you want in the email by typing the text. Okay, fix that. Boom. All right, let's scroll down. Here's your invoice. Thanks so much for the payment. You can edit this text in the message by tapping on it and typing anything you want. And of course, whatever you type here will show up in the email. Now, we're ready to send it. So we tap on the top right for send. Okay. And there you go. The invoice is sent. Now let's take a look at how it would look like, you know, what it would look like when Debbie Reynolds logs into her email and sees the invoice. Now here's the email from Video App Example Company with the paperclip attachment invoice from Video App Example. So we click on it, and you can see this is the summary that you get in the body, or your client will get in the body of the email. And then when you click View Invoice, another window in your browser will open up, and it will read it as a PDF. So here you are, 880, and you can see the date of the invoice, or at least the due date anyway, the balance due. And if you scroll down, you get the details. And of course, you could always click here for the activity. And then you could, the client can send you a message and send something back if they attach a file from their email. That's what it looks like. And again, if you go to invoice detail, if you know how to print from your browser, or your client knows how to print from their browser, you can save it as a PDF or print it. If you click save it as a PDF, you have to have the PDF software installed. And if you click print, the client would have to have a printer. Another great feature is that you can nag or harass your clients to pay if they don't pay by simply sending the invoice again. You can also nag and harass your customer to pay the invoice using the QuickBooks Online app. All you have to do is reopen the invoice, and again, it should be at the top of the activity list. Now it says send reminder because it knows we already emailed the invoice, and when you tap send reminder, okay, here you are, and again you put in the invoice number and you put in whatever text you want, type it in, and then all you have to do is tap the arrow in the top right. and it will send a reminder email.